So we're talking a little bit about a variety of things, including what people are claiming works for a certain condition and what people will believe. And it's interesting, ivermectin is commonly known as, well, it's a horse pill, basically. You've heard the expression, hey, this pill looks like a horse pill. Well, there are actual horse pills. Joe Rogan, which is a very popular podcaster, in fact, probably the most popular podcaster in America right now, claims, I guess, that he took it and it helped him with his symptoms, his COVID symptoms. I don't believe he's been vaccinated either. And so that's been a whole big brouhaha. People are getting excited about it. Others are saying you're absolutely crazy for ingesting something into your system that you shouldn't. Take it for horses. They shoot horses, don't they? Something that's famous about. But it's interesting what people will do and the crazy things that people will try. And maybe we can take a little offshoot here and talk about that. Think about all the crazy fads that have occurred in our lifetimes. And I'm not talking about medical fads, or we're lost with those. But the things that people latch onto and start to play around with. I mean, the hula hoop was the greatest example in the 30s, right? When everybody was into that, and then it died out, needless to say. But I remember watching TV in the 60s, and there were these ads on television for weight loss machines. One was that belt where you stand up, put the belt around your waist, and the belt would vibrate, and then hence the pounds would just melt away. I mean, it's stuff like that. It's quackery stuff that's been around forever. And Professor Marvel and his magical wagon would come into town and sell the elixir. That's still happening. And I know that there are a lot of people who believe in alternative medicines and things like that, Chinese medicine. And there are some that are effective for some things. But, man, you really are taking a chance when you're experimenting with stuff and taking stuff internally and listening to mystics or Sufis that can never tell you it's all good. There was a lot of studies back in the 90s, or a lot of, I shouldn't say studies, there was a lot of talk about something called St. John's Wort, and people were desperate for help with depression, and they would take St. John's Wort, because in Europe, apparently,